Right, folks, I'm going to start off with this with a few shout outs. I'm getting loads and loads and loads of people asking me for shout outs. I'm getting loads of people asking me to request to do certain foods. And I'm making a note, right? I'm making a list. And I am trying to work my way through, but every time I get to, then I get about another 10 more people asking me to do something. And please believe me, I'm trying to get round to you all, yeah? I'm trying my best now, but the more popular I'm getting, I mean, I'm on 30,000 subs at the moment, so it's getting a bit hard to reply to everybody. So if I'm just giving you a thumbs up on the comments, I do. Let me put my light on, because it keeps fading in and out here. There we go. How's that? Does that look any better? Righto. So what I'm going to do, folks, I'm going to do a few shout-outs right before the start of this review. And let's just go for it. People, you just keep asking for shout-outs, and I'm more than happy to do them. But please, sometimes I've noticed that I'm going through the messages, and the messages that I get on one thing don't seem to come up on another, and it's these loads. So if you don't get a shout-out, please, please come back, and I'll do it again. I know it's, sometimes it means a lot to people, and I don't want to miss people out. So anyway, here we go. Dylan Cook, right? Dylan Cook from Kate Cunningham. Weren't they in the Fonz? Weren't they in Happy Days, Cunninghams? They're a Brum fan. He's a Brum fan. And what happened today? The date is the 30th of March, I think. So what happened? Bearded Jammer. A big shout out to you as well, mate. And Zach Skinner. Let me put a line through. I'm going to put a line through you. So that one's done, that one's done, that one and that one. Right, I also have a big shout out to the Barnes of Falkirk. Better meddling with the Dell than the Barnes of Falkirk. And stop calling it soccer. Yeah, too right, it's football, isn't it? Soccer. We're not that side of the pond, are we? So now, I've also got one here now. And you've got to bear with here, right? It's a naughty word, right? It's a real bad word. It's not the C word. And the thing is, right, if you can just get your head round what I'm trying to say, this bloke, it's his name. It's his name. Now, it's just a black guy trying to help. But replace the black guy for another word that's not a nice word for black guys. But that's it. It's here. He's wrote it down. Just a... trying to help. I don't know. I haven't got a clue. Have you set me up there? I don't know. But I'm not going to say it, but I do respect it. Bump. All right, fist bump. That's not a punch in the face. That's a fist bump. Right, get rid of that now. Just cross him off so I don't do him twice. And there you go. Right, do you like that? Kid did that. Yeah, different, isn't it? Right, I have been to Melton Mowbray today. And the reason why I've been to Melton Mowbray is because Melton Mowbray is famous for a lot of things. It's got its Stilton and other nice foods, sausage rolls and stuff. They've also got a fairly decent local football team who are followed by the Pork Pie Army, who are flying high in their league at the moment looking for promotion. And there you go. So the Pork Pie Army, right, so what would they eat? Pies. Pork pies. And there you have it. Dickenson and Morris of Melton Mowbray since 1851, right? Somebody's asked me to do this. I can't remember who asked me to do it. So we've been out to Melton Mowbray today to have a walk around the town and buy this from Dickenson and Morris's shop. It's the real deal. No, it's not that bloke with the bloody orange skin. It ain't him who stands behind the counter going, cheap as chips. No, it ain't him. Yeah, these though, the we'll just say D&M, right? They D&M pork pies. I asked the lady behind the counter which is which, and she says the ones with the brown wrapping on are the ones that you can get in the shops and are sold all over the place. They are made in Leicester, yeah. But these in the white packet are actually made in the shop. They're cooked in the back. They've got the big kitchen cooking thing in the back. And these are cooked in the shop. So these are the traditional Melton Mowbray pork pie. You've got this thing where you can't make something that's called something in another part of the country or in another part of the world. It's like champagne, isn't it? Champagne can only be made in the Champagne area of France. And Stilton can only be made in Stilton areas and all that kind of thing, isn't it? What is it? Is it a 5 mile radius, 10 mile radius? I don't honestly know. So that's probably how they get around the pork pie thing with being made in Leicester. Melton Mowbray's only so many miles away from Leicester. And this, right, what I'm going to do, folks, I went in and bought, so I bought it. I didn't nick it. Went in and bought it. Now then, it's a handcrafted pork pie. Rich, crusty pastry, succulent pork and tasty jelly. Pork Pie Heaven from Dickenson and Morris. Made and baked here at Ye Old Pork Pie Shop. That shop spelled S-H-O-P-P-E. P-P-E. It's £5.95 and it's approximately a 380 gram pork pie. So that's quite a lot of money, really, isn't it? But because it is a Melton Mowbray pork pie, I thought I'd go that little bit further and pay the £6 for it to review this, because it is a traditional food in the English country and whatever. Why not visit Dickenson and Morris Ye Old Pork Pie Shop, 10 Nottingham Street, Melton Mowbray, Leicestershire, LE13 1NW. They've got a full website for orders. It's www.porkpie.co.uk. Give them a look. The shop was really, really good. It's got a nice lighting. They've got loads of cakes, and the sausage rolls look really tremendous. And they've just got loads of other stuff. And I should have bought more, really. But to be fair, I only went in for the pork pie, so that's the way it's going to be. The staff was quite... the staff was all right. They were okay. They weren't no special about them. They weren't in your face, big-headed or anything like that. You just went in, you asked for a pork pie, I asked the lady what they were about, and she gave me a nice, honest answer. You could tell she just knew. If I thought they were a pillock, I'd have said they're up their own arse and stuff like that, but they weren't. So you're okay. And they were quite friendly, and they were quite good. It's not easy working in a shop, I'd have thought, because you do come against some people who are complete idiots. And I suppose sometimes the difficult customers, and all you want to do is grab them around the back of the head and ram the face into the counter and that kind of thing. So I don't personally think I could actually work in a shop and be pleasant for the full 8-10 hours or whatever it is you're actually working there. I think I might actually turn around and say, why don't you just soft down to the next shop down the road? Yeah, I don't think I'd be good in a shop. So that's the pork pie. That does look traditional, good old pork pie, doesn't it? See, there's the little holes where they put the jelly in to give it that moisture, so it don't dry out. It's smells very nice, very, very nice. So let me just tilt that down so you can see that I am cutting the porker's pie. Ooh, that's it. I'm through. So that's the inside of the pork pie, folks. I don't think my lighting here does it justice. You've got the jelly on the outside of the pie. It looks a good, nice, crusty pastry. It smells absolutely lovely. It does smell really nice. Nice big lumps of chunk of pork's in there. Can you see that, folks? Can you see it in that bit? Look at that. Nice big chunk of pork there. Let me cut it again. I like to cut these things to see... Oh, look at that, all that grease. Well, not grease, all the fat, or, you know, the jelly. So that proves it's not dried out. I'm just going to go for the meat first, yeah? Oh, that's tender. Oh, that's bloody nice. That is tender as tender could be. Oh my God. That is absolutely outstanding. It's got herbs and spices in it that really mix well with the sausage meat and the jelly. To be fair, a lot of people don't like the jelly in the pork pie, and I can understand that because sometimes it just doesn't taste right to have that jelly. But this has got the right amount of jelly in. Look, if you can actually see there, that is the jelly, and it just seems to be the right amount. Don't get me wrong, right? I'm no pork pie expert. I know what I like, and that's it. And this is very nice. This is just, it's got a lovely, it's just got the right herb content. You can just feel the peppery or whatever it is. It's just there on your tongue, and it mixes so well with the pork pie. Let me try the crust. It has got a good crusty crunchy, it's not hard, but it has got a, it's got a crunchiness to it. That is good. I'll be honest with you, right, folks, when I picked it up, I thought, oh, that's burnt. That's a little bit, that's caught. Is that what they say, caught? But it isn't. It's quite nice. It's not burnt at all. Oh, here's the dogs. Yeah, I thought I was going to have to say, oh, it's been caught a little bit. It's been burnt a little bit. But it hasn't. That is spot on. They obviously know how to cook a nice pork pie. I would imagine at Christmas time, these guys and gals, well, I shouldn't say that really because it reminds me of Jimmy Savile too much. These men and women, they must sell hundreds of these damn things. They are absolutely spot on. But you don't just want my opinion, do you? You want the opinion of the dogs. So, who's up first? Who's up first? You gotta come up, mate. Come. Right. You take your time. Just take your time. Oh, here. That went down your tongue. Come here. Hold on. Oh, God. You got it? Yeah, he's got it. Right. You get down. Now you come up. That's it. You're not having any more. Get down. You'll be as fat as me. Go on. Look at that bloody dog slobber down there.
Did that go on my shirt?
A feather come through my shirt. How the bloody hell's that come out? Right. So, on the strength of that, that was a very, very nice pork pie. I've ripped the label, so you can't see it, but there you go. Dickenson's and Morris. One of the best pork pies. In fact, I'd probably say that's the best pork pie. Would I say that? It's up there. It's certainly up there. I do like a pork pie. They are... I mean, don't get me wrong. There's some crap out there. But that is so... Now, that's really nice because I've actually taken a bite with the meat and the pastry and it's all mixing in. Now then, flavours are working together. That is tremendous. Fortunately, folks, I actually work in Melton Mowbray. No, I don't make pork pies. I make plastic. Well, I'll be popping down and getting some more of that because I think the actual ones made in the shop are better than the ones you buy in the shop. The ones that are made in the shop, their shop, are better than the ones you buy in a shop. Can you see what I'm saying? All right, folks, I'm going to leave that there. Laters.